Now it's a pleasure to welcome Arnold Kienle. He is Business Development Manager of the Oscilloscopes and Protocol the division from Agilent, still Agilent at the moment, and he will give us some information about the activities and the new name which is coming in the future to the company. Please go ahead.
Yes, thank you. On November 1st, we will be pleased that the EMG division of Agilent Technologies will be Keysight Technologies. So we'll celebrate 75 years of test and measurement, and we're going to be a completely new company as of November 1st.
Okay. Thank you. You launched here at the show a new user interface for your oscilloscopes. Mm-hmm. Can you give us more details about this new user interface?
Yes, thank you. This is a very exciting user interface. We have a new Infinium version that allows the user to have three major benefits. One is faster and better documentation. Two, it allows the user to be completely flexible with the use of the oscilloscope, with the display, and how they view and arrange their waveforms and data. And then finally, we've improved the capability of using touch on the screen. Mm-hmm. And I could explain that a little bit later as well.
And are there certain applications where this new user interface is necessary or gives the highest degree of advantages also?
Well, as we've seen over the years, the use of oscilloscope has become a very general purpose instrument. And it's, of course, it's still today, but with various applications and protocol and compliance, looks like PCI Express, automotive applications, and more complex waveforms. Right now, a lot of the oscilloscopes cannot really handle that much information. And the user is more limited on what they could use on their display or the scope. Now, for the first time, we're going to provide the greatest flexibility. Mm-hmm. So for instance, if you look at protocol, we could separate all the protocol data and put it off on another side of the screen and maximize the waveform area. Yep. And in turn, if the user wants to focus more on the protocol, they could maximize and change the viewing area and really optimize and customize the user interface to their liking.
Is it comparable with the user interface of smartphones and tablets? Or is it special for the measurement?
There's various similarities. There's one thing about the tablet. As I mentioned, we have really looked into how we could improve the touch. Mm-hmm. And with our future oscilloscopes, we will be having or planning for capacitive touch screens. So we planned the touch in mind for that. And so we'll have multi-touch and the gestures that you find on smartphones. Yep. In addition, we allow some flexibility with the interface where you could have tabular views like internet browsers. Mm-hmm. So there's various things that we take from the mobile and portable products, as well as something that we use every day on the internet and desktop.
Okay. So when you mentioned the internet, how is the new oscilloscope linked to the internet, or is it remote controlled via internet interfaces?
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, because what I mentioned first is that we provide faster and better documentation. And what I mean by that is we found that now a lot of these customers and companies are global companies. A project is not just at one location. It may be around the world or even a different city. Yep. So how do people work together? So what we have done is you could save waveform files and all the data and notes, and then you could put that on the FTP site, and then you could share that with your colleagues, with your vendors, with customers, and then they could take our Infinium application, put it on their desktop, and have the full capability to analyze the data, look at it, make notes, share it, and then send it back and collaborate. Mm-hmm. So now it provides people a greater, faster way to really do work and do business with this new application that we're providing.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.